YouTubers!
Hello YouTubers! We are back with another empties video!
Oh yes, we have finished up quite a few things
over the past few months and we'll start with kind of skincare type of things.
The one and only body butter or body lotion we use is the Alverde body butter macadamia nut.
Yeah, the macadamia nut is in the permanent line and they also had a limited edition this time with blood orange. It smelled really good. Normally the standard line is always the best one, but this one was really good also. But it's limited edition, so the macadamia is our favorite. Yeah. And yeah, just to show you, we've used up quite a few. We've kept to show you.
And also we have used up our most loved favorite
makeup wipe. Yes. And ours is from Balea, which is a brand you can get in the DM drugstore shop. And these ones are just perfect to remove the makeup on the face. So again, we've kept a few to show you. And yeah, our favorite makeup wipes, they are inexpensive and they work so well.
And we love the pink one the most. They have different colors with different skin care ingredients. And we use the makeup wipes for every skin type. Talking about removing makeup, we have used up our Garnier makeup remover.
That's our favorite makeup remover to remove the eye makeup. It gets rid of waterproof eye makeup and all that. It's just great. We always go back to that one. And it's just the one with the two faces. Without perfume, without alcohol. Yeah, it's just a makeup remover we like a lot.
Then we have used up the toner. This was the sample size. It's the Kiehl's toner. Facial oil-free toner, yeah. It's a very good toner. I wouldn't repurchase it because Kiehl's is a very expensive brand and I'm very satisfied with my toner, which I'm using also from the brand Balea.
Then the next is eye creams. We have finished up, We have finished up the Origins Youthtopia eye cream, completely empty, and it's a firming eye cream with rhodiola. Yeah. The Youthtopia, it's okay, but I wouldn't repurchase it. I much prefer my Clinique All About Eyes Rich over this one.
Talking about Clinique, this is my favorite eye cream. It's the Clinique Anti-Gravity Eye Cream. Yeah, everything used up. I have been buying this eye cream since a year now and I'm loving it. And I will repurchase it over and over again.
She has already many times.
Yeah.
And I finished up my favorite night cream, which is the Estee Lauder Time Zone. It's for all skin types and this face cream or night face cream is so, I can't explain it. It's rich, but it really sinks into your skin so nicely and the next day when you wake up, skin feels so nice. I love that face night cream. It's not the cheapest one, but I love it. And all gone, all used up, and already repurchased also. Can't live without that.
Next empty item is the MAC brush cleaner. This is the only brush cleaner we are using. We are loving this brush cleaner and we will repurchase it again and again and again.
Yeah, another bottle which is empty. And actually we go through these brush cleansers quite fast because we are spot cleaning our brushes every day. Now also some perfumey things, and the ones we have used up, well, one that's kind of my staple perfume because my husband loves that on me, and it's the
that's
Chanel.
That's Camellia's staple scent.
Just probably because my husband loves it on me, and my husband generally loves the Chanel No. 5.
And there is another bottle of Eau de Toilette. This was not a perfume, this was just the Eau de Toilette. It's by the Naomi Campbell line. I don't know which one that was because she has more perfumes. They have different bottles and different scents.
With Naomi Campbell, since we can remember when we were like 17, 18, we have already always used the Naomi Campbell perfume. So we really like her scents.
Yeah.
Really like it. And the next perfume we have used up is the Viva La Juicy. It smells very, very good, but somehow I think it does smell as good on us.
Most of it I have used up and it's not my favorite perfume. The bottle is very, very cute, but...
And it looks nice.
Yeah, I don't think we will repurchase this perfume again.
Whereas Chanel No. 5 I will always repurchase.
And the next perfume is from Bruno Banani, not for everybody. It's the pink one, the light pink one, they have a lilac colored one, and I absolutely love this. This is an Eau de Toilette also. I'm wearing this Eau de Toilette every day when I go to work, when I don't use any other perfume, but mostly I'm using this one because the smell is great. I'm loving this. I will repurchase this over and over again.
That's Brigitte's everyday kind of set.
Moving on with makeup items, we have used up a few face primers.
Yeah, and if you want to see what we think about these primers, we have a primer review video on our channel. We also will link it down below. And the ones we've used up is the Shiseido Pore Smoothing Corrector Primer. As you can see, completely gone and empty. And the MAC Mattifying Cream.
As well as the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer, the pink one and the green one. Which one would we repurchase? I think the Smashbox, the pink one, Smashbox Face Primer was great, yeah.
Or we try out some others from Smashbox. We truly like the Smashbox primers. But if you want to hear more about these products, go and check out our primer review.
Then we have used up a foundation. This is a Bourjois foundation in the number 32 Rose Claire. Really like this foundation.
Bourjois foundations in general are quite good. And yeah, this one is a foundation we have used up, thank God, because...
Had here a little brush, what we didn't use, but...
That's the only annoying thing, don't like the brush here. It's really kind of messy, I prefer pumps. And yeah, since we have lots of foundation to go through this year, we are happy to have used up one of these already.
And I like this foundation better than the Healthy Mix from Bourjois.
Really?
Mm-hmm, I did, yeah.
Okay, didn't know that.
It reminds me a little bit of the Estee Lauder Double Wear foundation. It's just not that long lasting, but it was...
It's not as sticky, sticky. The Bourjois foundations in general are not as sticky.
Yeah. And it had great coverage, but great foundation, yes. And another foundation we have used up is the Misha BB Cream.
Yeah, like kind of a base on our face. We love that Misha BB Cream. As for eye bases, we have one product which we haven't used up, but look at it.
It's completely dried out.
Yeah, it's dried out and you can't use it anymore. It doesn't blend on the eyes anymore. You have to tug on your eyes because it's so dry. So we wouldn't use that anymore. So it's time to get rid of it. And it's the Benefit Creaseless Cream Eyeshadow in Bunny Hop.
And the other one, you have seen me using this product a lot in tutorials. It's the MAC Painterly Paint Pot. I'm totally through this and I loved it and I already repurchased it because, yeah, I really like it. Finally, I'm through my L'Oreal Voluminous Black Mascara.
A very nice mascara. We both really liked that mascara.
Oh, yes.
But we wouldn't pay more than 10 euros for a mascara like that anymore.
And I think the L'Oreal Voluminous Black Mascara is very, very similar to the Essence Black is Black mascara. So why should I pay more than 10 euros when I get a very good mascara for 2 or 3 euros?
And then we went through some face powders.
Yay!
One is the MAC Blot Powder in medium dark. Completely gone. I really, really, really like that powder. It hasn't got much coverage, but when you have high coverage foundation anyhow, it doesn't make it look cakey. It's beautiful on the skin and it's also very good for touch-ups. It's just a great, great powder. I love that. And yeah, when I've gone through some of the powders I'm using now, then it would be definitely something I would have a look at again and maybe repurchase again.
Next one is a translucent powder from Alverde. Nothing special, just a white translucent powder. Everything used up. I've used it for my under eye area mostly, and when I was wearing full coverage foundation, I've used it also to set the foundation. Yeah, I liked it a lot, but we have lots of other translucent powders which we have to go through, and so this will not be repurchased.
At the moment.
At the moment.
And another product from Alverde is the compact powder in 050 Terra. Completely gone. I've used that as a bronzer because it was a little bit darker and a little bit shimmery, so using that all over the face, even when we are a little bit more tanned, didn't work because it has shimmer in it. I don't know, it's funny, but it was great for using it as a bronzer and yeah, it's all gone. Next one is an eyeshadow I have used up. It was a sample eyeshadow from Estee Lauder. This Estee Lauder eyeshadow is called Sugar Biscuit and it's a satin finish. And we got that in a gift with purchase packaging thing, and we depotted it, and I've used that all the time in my inner tear duct and sometimes all over the lid. It was just a nice champagne-y shimmery eyeshadow. I thought it's that tiny, so it shouldn't be too hard to use up and make room for something else in our Z palettes. Then to lip liners. I'm very good at using up our purchased lip liners, and one is Rimmel Exaggerate in East End Snob. Just a very nice pinky lip liner, and yeah, they last very nicely and long on the lips. Formula is alright, but what we both didn't like really is the slanted tip here. So it's very kind of, it's easy to fill in your lips, but to line a precise line on your lips is quite, not hard, but just a little bit annoying. Rimmel lip liners are very good in general, and I did like that one too, but at the moment I don't have the desire to repurchase that one. And another lip liner I have used up, and finally I've used that one up because I really didn't like it, and it was from Agnes B, and it was just kind of a peachy pink. Didn't like that lip liner, didn't like how it went on the lips. I don't know, it was a little bit patchy and very hard, so it tugged on the lips a little bit. So yeah, glad it's gone, yay!
And a lip gloss, it's a lip maximizer from Alverde, just a regular nice pink lip gloss, which is empty now.
And then one thing we had to use up because it was getting over 2 years old was the Dior lip gloss duo. It was a limited edition packaging, 001 Addicted to Coral, and it had two really nice lip glosses in there, very sheer lip glosses. There was like a corally one, very sheer, and then one golden one with a little bit of sparkles in it, but the packaging was really nice. We will clean out that packaging and let's see, maybe we, I don't know, press some pigments in there, or
yeah, I don't know, because we don't want to throw this cute little box away.
Right, these were the products we have used up over the past couple of months or few months, and let's go on to face of the day.
On my eyes, I'm wearing something new. Catrice came out with a nude palette.
Yay, yay! They just came out with it, well, they just kind of rearranging their permanent line again. And yeah, this time they did something really, really good.
It's a really, really pretty palette with pretty colors. You have light shades, you have medium shades, and you have dark shades. For me, the dark shades are not dark enough. That's why I have used also my NYX black eyeshadow in my outer V. And now I'm showing you which colors I have used. The light color I have used for the inner tear duct. With this beautiful golden brown color, I went all over my lid. In the crease, I have this color here, and in my outer V, I have this darker color here, and also on my lower lash line, I have the darker color here. And my Bring Me Frosted Cake for my brow bone.
They did a good job on that one, but obviously a black color is missing, and
some matte colors are missing.
Yeah, they are all shimmery, but the eyeshadows are great.
Yeah, I have been using this palette for 3 days now, and I'm really enjoying it. To line my eyes, I have used the Black Track by MAC, and on my waterline, I have used the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Pencil in Midnight Cowboy. My mascara is the Dior Extase Mascara. And now for my face, I have used the Shiseido Primer, which we have shown before, and the Misha BB Cream. I set that with the Dior, with the Dior powder that was in a palette.
We showed that in a haul from summer. Yeah. We will link it down below, a collective haul, if you want to see that whole palette.
Yeah, we depotted it, and now I want to use it up, the powder. My concealer is the Garnier Roll-On. I'm sure you have seen it somewhere in our videos. And to set my concealer, I've used the Bourjois translucent powder. My blush today is the Deep Throat from NARS, and for contouring a little bit I have used my beloved Douceur blush.
And I'm gutted because I have dropped the NARS orgasm blush.
She has dropped her favorite blush
on the tiled floor. So the blush is okay, but the packaging broke, and I'm gutted. I'm so annoyed with myself.
My highlighter is the MAC Chez Chalamet. I'm loving this highlighter. And for lips, I have used my Gourlay lipstick in Joanna, and my Etc. lip liner from the Prolonger line, and the Dior Prune Fig. And my nail polish is from OPI. I don't know the name now, but I will put it in the info bar.
Talking about nails, now it's my turn. I'm wearing the Catrice Who Are Blue. This is a limited edition Catrice nail polish and oh, it's so gorgeous. Then I start with the face today. It's the MAC Prep and Prime Primer. And today is the Healthy Mix Bourjois Foundation in 52 Vanilla. I set that with the Bourjois Radiance Powder. Concealer is the Garnier Roll-On Under the Eyes. For face, that was enough coverage for me today. And to set the concealer, the Guerlain Meteoritz Pressed Pearl Powder thingy. My bronzer is the Chanel Tarn de Soleil bronzer. And the blush is from that palette. Here, the Kiss the Bride eyeshadow. Because I don't like wearing that eyeshadow on the eyes, but as a blush, I really, really like it. And on my eyes, I'm also wearing this Too Faced Romantic Eye eyeshadow palette. Soulmates in the inner tear duct, cut the cake on the lid, first dance in the outer corner, blended it in a little bit. With Unveil, I just darkened up the outer V. And again on the lower lash line, first dance in the outer third, inner third, cut the cake. And to blend everything out, I've used two eyeshadows from Alvere, which is in the chocolate eyeshadow quad from Alvere, and we've depotted that one. This is the blending out color, a very nice subtle blending color, and the white one from this quad for my brow bone. In my waterline, I have the P2 Open Up Your Eyes pencil, very nice pinky kind of pencil, and the Macro Violet, no, it's the Dark Diversion Fluid Line by MAC. To line the eyes. And my lips, one of my favorite lipsticks, I love it, is the Catrice Coralicious Pink, and underneath just a pink lip liner. We say goodbye for now.
Thanks so much for watching. See you next time in our next video.
Lots of love from Cornelia
and Brigitte.